recent graduate and resident alumni, George Fox. Welcome to Life After George Fox, a how-to and what's what guide to life for the George Fox graduate. Now that I've spent a year in the School of Hard Knocks, i.e. living next door to Coffee Cottage as an alumni loser, I have some worldly wisdom for you as you go out into the cold, cruel world of life outside the bubble. Shall we go and see?
Hey Ben, they were all out of Monsters, Inc., so I got the new VeggieTales again.
Liquor.
It's pronounced liquor, and it's French for alcohol.
Those crazy French, they have a word for everything.
Yes, and decent Americans have a few words for it, too. Here in the real world, we call it hooch, booze, the sauce, and Satan's blood. Although the substance may be tempting to try, believe me when I tell you, I know the dangers of hooch firsthand.
Man, that must have sucked bizza.
Could you please hold off on the vulgarity until the swearing scenario?
Va-shizzle.
Carrying on. You must acquit yourselves of the sauce and lesser drugs, like PCP and ganja. If you're an educated person.
Which we are.
Now, thanks to you, Ron.
You will avoid anything French. This includes liquor, cigarettes, and Chevrolets. And of course, sin.
Your Benz are fans? They're so arrogant over there.
You know, I heard they're a bunch of long-haired, hippie, pinko freaks.
Oh my goodness, that guy's hand is on fire.
We gotta put it out.
He just ate something about fire, man.
He must be a witch. Yeah, I know this. I saw it in the crucible.
Yeah.
They breathe in some of the fire, and then they breathe out the soul of a baby they had eaten earlier.
Oh, you know, technically, he'd be a he-witch.
Right.
This practice is conveniently labeled smoking. And yes, witches do smoke and eat babies.
Smoking, huh? Sounds strangely satanic to me.
He is a witch! He's a he-witch!
Case in point. Although it's never been proven.
The last 3 seconds have been paid for by Philip Morris.
Smoking can be habit-forming and detrimental to one's health.
So, smoking is a habit that can kill you, huh?
Like sin?
Smoking is a lot like sin.
It's broke!
Nah, this here flux capacitor just needs more fluid.
Nah, just hit it.
Well, no, man, there are rules here, Smokey. This isn't NOM.
That's like your opinion, man.
Ah! French!
I mean, ow!
Calm yourself, Todd! My ears are burning! Cock-a-poo-poo!
Ah!
As you enter the world of heathens, Democrats, or if you should be so unlucky, the French, you will undoubtedly hear words far worse than you've heard here today. This is called cursing, or swearing, sinning with the mouth. Words like fudgesicles and cock-a-poo-poo, these sound more like frozen treats, not expletives.
No,
if you go around saying things like that, people will think you were trampled by a fat heifer as a child.
Heifer! That's a good one. Todd, you're a heifer.
Wolf fiddly deed. What are we supposed to say when we're all hot-headed and blush-faced?
Should we say something like, heck slash darn?
No! No! You should say something more like,
rubber band.
That didn't make any sense.
Exactly. Swearing is illogical.
How'd you find such a great part, Courtney?
Oh, you know, I just made a call.
That male is physically attractive to me, and I wish to pursue a lasting relationship with him that results in the birth of his children.
I second that, except I wish to be romantically involved with his twin brother, assuming, of course, that he has one.
No, but seriously, he's flaming
hot. Oh, yeah!
Seems you ladies are a bit confused about your feelings right now.
No, we're not!
Well, I'm here to help. These ladies are experiencing what we call in the psychological world, Twitter patient. For you lay people, that's the hots. Actually, what you are experiencing is not full Twitter patient, but rather partial Twitter patient. As the male you are so fascinated with is not actually hot, in the broad universal sense of the term. He is, however, George Fox hot.
Hey!
Which is relatively hot, within the confines of the George Fox University community.
But if he's only George Fox hot, then what's absolute hot?
Well, people like Enrique Iglesias, Brad Pitt, and me.
What? Brad Pitt?
Allow me to demonstrate. It's better to see when it's juxtaposed. Hot,
George Fox hot.
Hot,
George Fox hot.
Hot,
George Fox hot.
Not at all hot.
Thank you, Ron. We could have made a horrible mistake.
That's right. He was probably French. Or a sinner. As if the two could be separated.
This has been a short lesson in life after George Fox. I had the privilege of introducing many of you to this community, and now I've had the privilege of getting you ready for real life. And don't ever forget the great wisdom of Chuck the Spoon Cop. Remember when he used to say,
"Careful, men, it's a jungle out there."
Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Or would you run and never look back? Would you cry if you saw me crying? And would you save my soul tonight?